Hi, I'm Lauren, and I'm going to be talking to you about the way that God speaks to us. Now, before you hang out with me, you're going to go want to watch the Meeting House video for this week. So I'm going to give you a few seconds to pause the video, go watch that, and then come back. Okay, well, if you're back, then I'm just gonna have to trust you that you watched that video, okay? Scouts honors, right? Okay, so you'll notice we're still talking about Moses this week. Now, the point that we left off in the story is when Moses was just kind of chilling. He had just gotten married, he's working for his father-in-law. Like, he has a good life, just tending sheep, just living life, right? Well, one day he's living that life and he sees a burning bush, which I guess isn't too unusual, but it's definitely weird. But then the bush talks. Imagine if one of your houseplants started talking to you, or actually if any plant started talking to you, wouldn't you be freaked out? I know I would be, most certainly. So he's freaked out, and now this bush is telling him to do some crazy, scary stuff. The bush is telling him to go back to a place where the people don't like him. The Hebrews don't like him because they don't know him that well. And the Egyptians don't like him because he killed somebody. Like, it's just not something he wants to do. And then he has to go in and ask for a really big thing. Oh, even if I was faced with a crazy talking plant, I would be very scared to do that myself. So understandably, he's hesitant. But the thing is we gotta listen. We gotta listen to God's voice because he's telling us to do things that'll be helpful for everyone. Helpful for yourself, helpful for your family, all the things like that. So now also the other thing about Moses' story is a burning bush that talks is a huge sign. And I don't know about you, but I don't see a lot of burning and talking bushes around. So sometimes God speaks in different ways. Now let's think about even people talk in different ways. I know I have friends that they talk to me by sending me memes or emojis, but then I have other friends who will talk to me with very big words, or other friends that'll just send me messages that are fully written out with good punctuation. So even people talk a little bit different. So there are a couple different ways that God can talk to us. He can do it through songs, through pictures, or just being out in nature, and through other people, and through the Bible. Now, speaking of the Bible, you guys have a monthly Bible verse. So let's go look at that. So it is 2 Corinthians 12:9. My grace is all you need. My power is strongest when you are weak. So I am very happy to brag about how weak I am. Then Christ's power can rest on me. Well, I hope you guys are memorizing that. Because I don't know if Dave has given you anything for memorizing it, but I hope so. So keep working on that. And so with that, your time with me is done. So what I want you to do this week is I want you to listen. I want you to listen very hard and pay attention because God may be trying to speak to you, but you have to have your ears and your eyes open to hear. Okay, everybody, have a good rest of your week, and I hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Bye.